This is weird. Come on. Sorry about it. I have a microphone up here, but I don't know why it's not working. USB.
MP sound device. Okay. Hello, hello. Can you hear me? Hopefully, now I see that thing moving, so hopefully you can hear me, but I don't see any chat. Oh God. Oh God. How is it now? I'm gonna look for a cable later. Video is like one frame per minute. Oh my God. And it says encoding overloaded. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the microscope. I'm gonna turn off, what about my composite? And let me know if it gets better. Okay, I see now some text. Reboot, Florida. Oh God, I'm running on Wi-Fi, yeah. Oh God. Yeah, maybe it's, but it worked well last time. Oh God. Overloaded. Hello, hello. Oh God. I may need to put this in a, Jesus. How's that, guys? Better now? only two cameras on. Okay. Is this okay still? Yeah, I know. I just want to make this nice for you guys. So, I'm gonna have to put this, hopefully, yeah. Hey guys, hey Joey, Justin, Herb, hey Kate, everybody, thank you very much for coming. Sorry for the delays. I think I'm gonna get a Ethernet cable for this machine for the next time. So please let me know, because I of course, I don't know if you guys are seeing anything or anything like that, but two cams is good. Yeah, I had a microscope and stuff, but you know, I'm not Joe, so anyway, let's start. Let's say I got this very yellow joystick, CH, and it came with the button stuck. Oh, it says stuck button, and look, I just push it and it came out. Okay, so it's good now. Okay, I'm gonna turn off my face camera, and I wanna turn on the composite so we can see. Hopefully it won't die. So we can see how. Yeah, I fixed it already. Jesus H Christ. So hold on. Boom. Let's go and go back to test. So I connect this joystick here and. Hold on. Okay. So, look, it's working. It's working. Okay, okay. Oh, the joystick doesn't work at all. Oh, okay. Well, I got something to fix. It doesn't move. Okay, but the buttons say it was stuck. and I just push it twice and it got out. So anyway, the joystick itself is not, look, it's doing something weird. Show's over. No, wait. Let's see what happens here. So let me reconnect. And I still don't see anything. So anyway, well, let's open it. Let's see what happens here. So what I do is I open it with like a little pallet or some, you know, just a little wood so I don't break anything. And if something breaks, is the wood. Another thing that I do, of course, is get all these in a little, all these parts in a little container so I don't lose them, because it happened to me all the time. I lose parts. So there it is. And in these joysticks, the 4 feet, we gotta take them out. And most of the time that little thing stays there. So what I do is with some pliers or something like that, I take out the little piece that it still stays there. So, oh God. So I just found out the wrong way that this computer cannot handle several things, you know. And I got a very powerful computer in the other place, but you know, I was trying to use something that I already have that I don't use too much. That maybe that's why I don't use it too much, huh? No, I'm sorry. Yeah, DSA pliers. Sorry. Yeah, these are tweezers, and these are actually very good tweezers, guys. I think my dad gave them to me, and they're very, very strong. My dad used to do watch repair, so he has cool tools. So here we go. And again, I just received this joystick, so it needs to be retro bright. As you can see, it's different color. And I just figured, you know, let's do it online so people can see what it takes to fix, just like Joe does it, because he likes to show off. Did you like the candle? Oh, that was a problem. My candle, where I can show it, it's all gone because I've been lighting it so much. Okay, so let's see. I'm still moving it. You see the buttons work, but I don't know why it's the rest is not working. There's the power. The power is a red one, and it goes to the buttons, and it goes to the potentiometers. And this pot is actually sideways, so let's straight it up. And the other one is also sideways, so maybe that's a problem. Let's see. No, I still don't see anything. This is strange. Maybe that was why Joe was feeling so bad, because you know his candle was completely gone. Okay, so I don't know if there's like an issue with the cables. I don't think so, because you know the buttons show current. And again, it's funny that they say, oh, the button was stuck, and all of a sudden it started working. And these buttons, as you can see, the that's why I like these joysticks. They're actually keys. I think that they are Mac, I don't know, but they're like normal key switches from a keyboard. So they're very strong, very sturdy, and they just go in there and click. They they get there. So why is not giving me any? The first thing that I may have to do is just take it out, take it in. Maybe it's not giving good connectivity. But if it's powering the buttons, and you can see that it's doing something over there. Yeah, buttons are not registering, yeah. Okay. And hold on, why is this outside and the power here is inside and the power here is outside? I think the power should be here, isn't it? And then this should be outside. No. That's strange. Let me get out. Get in again. No, still no. No signal. No, I don't think it's my 2C. See, reconnect my connectors on the computer. But if I'm getting signal, yeah, you see? Well, let's do one thing. Let's test another joystick. I have tons of them. Oops. Don't break it. Got another one here. Oh, did I do so? Oh damn. There it is. Let's see, I have one that works. Let's test it. Oh yeah, it's a program. What? This is weird. Sorry guys, let me open this bigger because I'm a little bit. Yeah, easy to see. Let's try it again. Okay, there's a cursor. Now, let's connect this one. Ah, there's a cursor. Oh, don't tell me this is... fine. Oh god. Okay, well yeah, it's nice that it's fine, but I wanted to fix something. Okay, why not? Oh god. Alright guys, so this was supposed to be bad and now. And that's why I love these joysticks, because they're so strong. Look, all the way up, all the way down. 255, zero. Oh gosh. So you see, it's, yeah, exactly. What do I fix now? Jeez. What I want to do later, guys, is I want to do one fixing that Macintosh, not fixing, converting it. But I got to put everything together, that's why. I'm telling you, magic hands. It's like, fix yourself. I should have light the candle. Oh, Isn't it weird that it works now? Okay. So, and this was stuck and they sold it to me like the button didn't work. So I thought it was broken inside. Like sometimes it breaks on the edges over here and it just stays down, but it was just stuck and I guess the person that sold it to me didn't touch it enough times. So the purple button Gravis. No, I haven't. So I got this Gravis, and this is a PC version, and I just cut it. I say, oh, I'm just gonna cut it and convert it, and the cables are not the same. So the configuration is not the same as the all other Gravis that has also, because this one has two buttons on top, and the other one only has one, and so this is a different model. So I still haven't been able to figure it out, and it moved a little bit, but not everything. So I need to work on this. But this is really. Yeah, my streaming gear had more problems than my joystick. Yeah, I'm gonna maybe I'm talking to Joe or maybe I'll talk to somebody else and see what can I do. Maybe if I put Ethernet on USB on this machine. Maybe it has an Ethernet. I think it has an Ethernet connector over there. But then I gotta put a long cable. Yeah, but maybe the Ethernet would do that. Yeah, this is a strange model, but it's cool, isn't it? Because you can see everything. So I'll fix it. I'll make it work. I even have that. You see what I do? I cut this. That those are my secrets. I cut a normal cable like this one. Cut it like that, and then I put the. One of these connectors, and I put it in. Before I used to just cut the long one and just leave it like that, but now because it cost me like, I don't know, $6 to buy a cable that has these rubber cases, and then I just cut it and put it in there, and it almost looks, when you glue it, it looks almost brand new or original. So now that's what I'm doing. If you do this and you put it like that, it looks original. Once it's glued, it works. So cut six cable. Yeah, because it's not going through Wi-Fi, isn't it? Yeah, I'm gonna try to run a cable directly over here. I think that's gonna help a lot. Because I don't think the machine is telling me the CPU is, well, now it says 38%, but it was before it was like 20%. So, but of course I added several things. I added, this is a, let's see if you can see it. Yeah, this is a microscope. So I added the signal from the microscope because I wanted to be like Joe, because I want to be cool. but yeah, I want to be cool, but I'm not rich, so I cannot afford one of those uber great microscopes. So this is what I can have. So I wanted to do that. But anyway, I haven't needed. I really don't need it right now. So the other one is, of course, I connected the Apple IIc, and I think this is good, isn't it? Yeah, I'm telling you, I'm honorary Canadian. Eh? Am I Canadian? Eh? Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You're right, Joe. But it's good. It's good. Okay, so what do I do now, guys? Jesus Christ. When I want to... And you know what? I need people to begin to send me their joysticks to fix, because I fixed everything and I don't have anything to fix. I can show you what I was doing also today. I was retro writing this. I think I put a photo of this. This is a modem. This is the Data Modem 2400. Let's see if you can see it. Yeah, there it is. Data Modem 2400. And, okay, I can play a game, yeah. And I just to show you, this is one of the worst things to open in the world. I'm telling you, I was I almost told the guy that I was not going to do it because, you know, he's very nice and he asked me, hey, could you do that? And I said, yeah, no problem. But then to open it, it has these two little tabs on the back. And as you can see, they go over here. And boy, I'm telling you, this is so crazy because there's nothing to open it. You know, there's no screws or anything like that. So to open it, you got to push it in here and then put something in there and begin to open it from the front. And then, of course, this little button begins to move around. And then you gotta then push out like this. And then you gotta, in this part, you gotta push this in so it open. But it's you know, I was afraid I was gonna break it. I was afraid I was gonna, you know, damage the plastics or anything like that. And it has some things over here, but I didn't do those. Oh, okay, this just get in. So yeah, before, I don't wanna close it because if I close it, I'm not gonna open it anymore or again. So just wanted to show you the interior of this is cool. And it has a little thing for that. I suppose it's the volume. And then over here, there's some lights and there's a button over here. So it's retrograded. I'm just getting ready. I'm gonna put back the little logo. And it came out nice. You know, it was really yellow. And I did this. All right, I close it. There it is. It's closed. I cannot open it anymore. But it's okay, because it came out good. Do you want to play a game? That's not difficult. For that, I'm prepared. I'll just turn it off. Connect my beautiful W drive. And let's see. No, I want total replay. And of course, my two C's sideways. Oh, there it is. Total replay. And because we have a joystick and it's really good, I can play we can use this one. I haven't finished it, but I can use it. So let's play, what do you want to play? Hard Hat Mac? I love Hard Hat Mac. H. There it is. Let's make it bigger. Because I don't want you to see my. Okay, Hard Hat Mac, where are you? Is my volume up? Yeah, it is up. Oh yeah. Oh gosh. You see? I'm not used to see such small screen. Well, no, actually, it's okay. It's a good screen. Wait for this guy. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Give me that. Oh, God. Oh, you know what? It has like a delay or something like that. Yeah, let's blame it on the delay, not on my crappy skills. Let's try with a better joystick. Well, not better, but the other one, it's a little bit, it doesn't have the feet, so it feels like weird. Thank you. Oh God, it had to take me. I'm telling you. Game over, man. Game over. Oh. Lemon stand. Send it to see the to see video. It's a cheap El Cheapo composite to USB adapter. I would love to show it to you, but it's on the back of the computer, and it's just a little USB thing that has the three of them: the composite, the what's in this one? The other one, the S video. And left and right audio, so that's it. But it's pretty good. It's pretty good image, isn't it? For El Cheapo, it's pretty good. Oh God! Game over, man. Game over. I knew it. This reminds me that in K-Fest we were, come on, we were playing on the entrance, on the main building. There's a big TV, and we were playing over there. Oh God, that has a delay. I thought I had. Second, yeah, blaming on the delay. I know that. Oh gosh, I love Spanish speaking guy uses a phrase El Cheapo. Yep. Go to the second level. Come on, come on. Oh, go down. Oh. Chop lifter. Remember that one? That was funny. With I was competing with several guys. Now, you know what? Let's go and play, and I'm trying to use the keyboard up here. Let's play. Oh, look, doesn't want to go. Total replay, oh yeah. Oh, they just came out with a new version, the 5.0. You saw that, guys? So I'm ready to download it. What do I like? Dung Beetles. Dung Beetles, where's Dung Beetles? No, not here. Oh yeah, Chris Torrance, yeah. Damn you, Chris, you killed me. Where am I? Okay, Dung Beetles is D, and then you go forward once. And that's it. Yeah, this is one of my favorites. Because it has the La Cucaracha, you know? I feel at home. Oh, I hate it when it generates these ones that they don't go anywhere. They end in you know, close things. And oh, it was gonna take me. Yeah, when it does, look at this. When it does random ones that they end up in closed sections, I hate that. What am I doing? I was just lucky there. I mean, I'm not Kate playing these awesome games. She's great doing the... Oh, God. You see? Sucks to be me. Yeah, this maze looks a lot better. It's good quality, huh? Well, I definitely need to upgrade my video equipment, but at the same time, I'm happy that at least it works and I can do these things. I can always, you know, do these things better and get better equipment later. Like I told you, I have a very good computer, but I think if I only add an Ethernet cable, it's gonna make a big difference. So I think, yeah, the Wi-Fi is crippling it a lot and making it a little bit stuttering, you know? Rudy, you're asking what's 5.0? That's the fifth version of Total Replay. So 4 a.m., oh gosh, 4 a.m. just released a new version of Total Replay, or Total Replay, and it has a bunch of new games, cheats, and upgrades. And so he should get it. Yeah, thank you, Joe. I saw it on the messenger, but I haven't been able to. I'm gonna do it today or tonight. And yeah, definitely. And you know what? I think the Wi-Fi, because this is a Hackintosh also, I think it's a feed that is working actually. Because this is a little ThinkPad that I'm using with macOS Big Sur running there, and it actually runs pretty well for what it is. So I think I should help it with oh god, yeah, everybody was around me. Yeah, I should help it with Ethernet, because I think that the Ethernet card that has in there, or the Wi-Fi card that has in there, is pretty crappy. The problem is that a lot of I don't know you guys, but I don't. Yeah, Rudy, you're right. The thing is that, you know, guys, I get rid of most of my Ethernet cables some time ago because, you know, everything was going Wi-Fi. So I don't have too many Ethernet cables anymore. And I need a long one because my router is on the other side of the room. So, yeah, I'm going to need a long, long one. So I'm going to look for someone. You guys, let me know if you want to play something else. I'm just addicted to this little game. Yeah, Joe, you should give some consulting to people that want to do this video streaming, because you really know everything, man. You see, you glance for a second to the chat, and boom, they kill you. I So people ask me, how do you play games like every day or every other day on your Apple II? Don't you get bored? No, these are cool games. And thanks to 4AM, now we got like tons of them in one place, you know? You don't have to be looking for floppies and anything. Oh, gosh. I went directly to there. Oh, Bruce is there. Howdy, mate. Or let me see, how do you do it? Howdy, mate. I wish I could do the other accents, man. But no, my accents are lame. I already got an accent. So I should stick with it. I always try to finish an area, but I think I'm gonna go all the way around. Or not. You know? Dung beetles is like life. It's whatever the maze takes you. Oh yeah, and I can see that, you know, it goes faster sometimes and has some delay sometimes. That's why also they catch me. Because oh, jeez, oh! They were ready to kill me. I was lucky. Oh. You're not even trying. Music for your truck. Truck horn, oh yeah, yeah. Just, you know, put a microphone and take it from here. It would be awesome. Your truck that has that, but with the 8-bit sound, that would be great. Maybe. I'm telling you guys, I was thinking about that the other day. You know, it's easy for an English-speaking person to do the accents of English-speaking accents, you know what I mean? Like, you know, British and, you know, Irish and all that. Same with us, you know, the Spanish. There's a bunch of Spanish accents, and it's very easy for us to do those. But for a Spanish-speaking person trying to do an English accent, it's already difficult because it's already difficult to speak English, you know what I mean? Oh, God. Run, Javier, run. Yeah. You see, I almost got it. Oh, God. Maybe because I'm lefty, but I always go to the left lower area of the maze. I don't know. Kind of like this area. Oh God, I hate those. And he was on his way to get me, you saw that? I was gonna read, but oh, they almost got me. Oh, can't read the comments, cannot. Star Wars. Hey, it's actually pretty funny. Yeah, they got the Spanish. They say, Luke Esquivalker. instead of Luke Skywalker. And that, when the first time I heard that, I was just laughing out loud. Hey Bruce, what happened to my motherboard? You haven't got it yet? Because I'm about to make another Mac SE, and I was thinking that I could use that one. But you know, whatever. The universe didn't want me to have an SE30. That SE30 is like the 840 of poor Steve. Oh, so a Mexican accent? Yeah. Oh, yeah. French butcher English. Yeah, that's another one. You know, there's Canadian and French accent. I cannot identify them at all. Let's play another game. And I hear it all the time. Yeah, no, Canadian and French accent are very different, blah, blah, blah. I cannot at all. Although, you know, when I came to the US, I couldn't recognize other Spanish accents. And I couldn't, you know, understand, you know, from, well, Argentinians, yes, they are very, very strong, but Colombians and Venezuelans, I didn't really could relate them. And then a few years later, when I started listening to it, let's play Alien Downpour. I'm gonna die here. Then I can recognize all the Spanish accents. You know, it's, they got their little things, but I, you know, before living in Mexico, I didn't hear any other accents but Mexicans, you know. And of course, in Mexico, there's like three or four different accents too. Oh, Bruce, you're behind? Yeah, but you got it already, at least, isn't it? Come on, come on. Joystick. What? Why? I say joystick. Oh, come on. No, it didn't took joystick. Oh, gosh. All right. J. Oh, got it. Okay, let's look for another one. Oh, of course, Karateka. Yeah, guys, next time I tell you guys that I'm going to fix a joystick, it's not going to be a CH, because they're too sturdy, too good. I could use an accelerator here. Yeah, I was gonna fix a joystick, and then the damn joystick fix itself, so I had nothing to fix. No, that I get it when I go to Mexico, the Montezuma revenge. Yeah. Pretty good quality, huh? I'm telling you, never use a little laptop machine to do streaming and then put everything in there. Now I have no drop frames at all, but it says my CPU is 37%. Last time we were doing it, it was like 27%, but yeah, I think the two, there was only two sources. Yeah, right. Natural streaming. I'm natural breaking things, guys. That's why I'm natural. That's why Joe loves me, because he has a lot of things to fix after me. The great thing about this is I don't break things that they send me to repair or to retrobrite, so that's a good thing. If not, I would be just paying things all the time, you know? Yeah. Every time, you know, Joe feels like he has nothing to repair, you just have to talk to me and I'll break something for him. Actually, I have one of those Sinclairs that I got two of them and one doesn't work, and that's gonna be for Joe, but I haven't had time to send it to him. So he can fix it on a stream. And that's gonna be a difficult one because it's, I think I have a cable, no problem. It uses one of those SCART cables. Yeah. I do actually have an original one. Yeah, I have one. I bought one and it looks ugly. And then my copies also have my reproductions have the flip one also on the other side. Oh, I got actually a couple of trackballs for Apple II coming hopefully tomorrow. And, here comes the eagle, guys. No, it's true. The thing with the Karateka is Jordan Mechner did it upside down as a joke, exactly, that if you put it on the other side, it would just play upside down. It's funny. Really? Did you guys saw that they did a new Prince of Persia for the Atari, and they did it, you know, modern, and it has, the graphics are amazing, you know, and the music is also very good, and it's for the Atari 8-bits. Because before, I think the Apple II version was the best looking in 8-bits. I think. But they just came out with that Atari, the remake, and it's beautiful. God, I was trying to. Yeah. Here it comes again. Oh, God. Yeah, I'm not good at that. Yeah, he messed with my hair. Ha! That's right. And I don't miss it. Do it. There's some guys that are better if you hit them on the head, and other ones that you gotta hit them on the legs. Yeah, just for that new Prince of Persia, I would like to get an Atari 130 XL, I think it is, or something like that. Yeah, Atari had always very nice graphics. Did I set up the boot menu? No, I normally use it over here, but this is the. Yeah, I don't use the on-screen one, although I should, but you know, I don't. And it's pretty easy, just do a reset, and it won't display anything by default, and it will show it on the screen. And if you want, of course, certain games to show first, I just put a 0 before, or 0, 1, 0, 2, and that's it. On the file name. No more eagle. Oh, yeah, eagle, eagle. Yeah. Got your eagle. And of course, shameless plug, I got a Karateka hitting an eagle on my 8BT's t-shirt store, so you can get that one, yeah. And you can hit the eagle all the time. Oh, yeah. Come on, come on, come on. Kill it. So, Joe, you have done this. You get one of those motherboards for the SE Reloaded or something like that, it's called. Where do you get all the components? Or you gotta get a bad SE motherboard and just transplant everything? Transplant? That's a yes. Yeah, that's what I thought, that maybe I have to get a bad SE30 or SE motherboard that has like a battery damage and try to get it. Couple of them can be taken from the dead SE. Oh, the other way. Okay. I need to get a. Because I'm thinking, yeah, if I don't get a motherboard for that green one, I may use that one. Yeah, I have the motherboard, but it's of course bare bones, so I gotta buy all the components. That would be another one to show, you know, to do a streaming on soldering. Finally, sheesh. Where's the eagle? I heard it. Yeah, that's why I always love these joysticks because they're so sturdy. You see, it fixed itself. I thought it wasn't working, and you know, the guy that sold it to me said it was bad, and you know, it was, you know, for parts, and the button wasn't working. So I was like, well, let's try to fix it online. The only thing I'm gonna have to do is retrowrite it, you see? Really yellow. And it's been funny here in Florida. It's sunny in the morning and then in the afternoon it rains, and then later it comes out, the sun comes out again, so you need to set the time for retrobrite. It's kind of cool because actually the rain will clean it up. After retrobrite, I don't have to wash it. You guys know that there's a two player version of Karateka, isn't it? That Charles Manjin did. He modified the code code, so there's a two-player version. You know, you can play against somebody, one with a joystick and the other one with a keyboard, I think. And one of the Kansas Fests, Jordan Mechner, I think he lives in France, and he did a video conference, and he told them he was impressed with his job. And it was fun. Yeah, I think I'm going to order a cable, a long cable, an Ethernet cable. Is there any cool Ethernet cables nowadays, or just, you know, normal cable? Any, you know, maybe they got like, I think I got a, what do I do here? I think it was a, oh, I knew it. Oh. All right, guys, I think I'm going to stop it now. Say I'm a little frustrated that didn't work. Well, it worked too well. But I'm going to order a cable, and maybe on the weekend, over the weekend or next week, I'll do another one with more things and cut six. Cool. Yeah. And if anybody wants to send me any joystick to fix, that would be cool, because now I don't have any joysticks to fix. And tomorrow I'm gonna get trackballs that I've never seen, so hopefully I'll be able to play with those. Cat 5e, okay. Cat 6, I think Cat 6 is good. Morning tea time. Alrighty, everybody. I really appreciated you stopping by. Sorry that it was a short project. I'm gonna leave it open because tomorrow I'm gonna retro write it. I'm gonna disassemble it and retro write it. And these are easy to disassemble. Just let me do it before I finish. Let me do this so you can see how it's disassembled at least. Just push it. And then push out these two guys, and you're done. Take this out. They're normally not soldered, so you take them out, and then put them in again, so you don't forget where they are. They go. And that's it. Same here. You got your parts. All right, guys. Good night. Thank you very much for joining. And I promise I'll fix my issues. Let me change the view.